IVM.
All right, simplified is where they take stories that you can't understand and make it even more difficult to understand. If you need that in your life, it's called marriage. Simplified, three young men with a mission. Their names, Chuck, Naren and Sriket. That's right, simplify their names first. Simplify, simplify. New episodes out on the IVM podcast website, app or wherever you get your podcast from.
कृपया ध्यान दीजिए, the language used on the podcast may not be fit for consumption. We warn you, tread carefully. But listen yaar, don't be so conservative. Okay, I accept that I don't have the best phone in the business. But I'm sick of people picking on me whenever I take the phone out. I've been doing a show with a lot of people, evening show, so a lot of people, you know, pass you by and some people look at this and say, oh, what a crappy phone. Why don't you get a better phone? Should I give you a phone? Take my old phone. You know, I want to say one thing here. You are not defined by the phone you have. You are defined by who's in your phone. Huh? Amit Shah. Hmm? Amitabh Bachchan. Huh? Ambani. All this is a A only. Wait till I go to B. Huh? All right. It's called Cock and Bull with four different people. Kajol is back. Amit Doshi, Silverie, our producer, and myself. Want to check?
I know.
We'll be back after this break, though. Yeah.
Are you looking for India's most awesome cricket podcast? Are you now tired of listening to the same old guys drone on about cricket everywhere? Edges and Sledges is a weekly cricket podcast hosted by three fans of the game, Varun, DJ, and myself, Ashwin. It was established in early 2018, has over 60 episodes now, and is of course now proud to be on the IVM Podcast Network. Each week, we get together from three different time zones, the USA, the UK, and Singapore, and we talk about things from the world of cricket, with a focus on Indian cricket. We often interview special guests from all around the world, including former cricketers and cricket media personalities. So check out Edges and Sledges, the cricket podcast, now on the IVM Network.
Also excited because today is our 499th and a half episode.
Well,
we are rounding up to 500. Yeah. Am I right?
We just turned the corner.
We just turned the corner. Kajol, please look excited for me.
I'm very 500. Excited.
This is that Brian Lara figure. 500. I've crossed into, you know, Everest. I'm Edmund Hillary and Tenzing Norgay. Mm-hmm. We've reached. I'm saying hi. We've reached together. Yes.
500.
500. Let's give ourselves half a clap.
Yeah.
Let's not do too much.
Yeah.
1,000 is the figure that you know. Then you've set some standard. 500 is nothing.
Well, 500 is just a start, right? Yeah. I mean, like, it is probably still more than
Ram
show,
Singh,
right?
My Bhelwala at Malba Hill, does 500 Bhelpuris a day. 500. So 500 over, what, 5 years is not.
Dude, that's
not
a lot.
Yeah, I just made that up. You know, never verify. This is not a show to be verified.
No, because I mean, like, when you started doing that, like, I just started doing math in my head. I'm like, oh my God, 500 a day. That means
hey,
that he's
boss,
making...
on a good day, on a Saturday or something when he's crowded, he puts away 100, 200 bail puris. Huh? No, so, I'm saying bail as for everything.
No, but 500 doesn't sound unreasonable. It doesn't sound unreasonable. If he's working for six hours, he's putting up like a
very
plate
often
to 1 hour.
I go and I take three, one for each kid and me.
Yeah.
All right, and that's it takes him 5 minutes to make.
Exactly.
5 minutes standing there.
So
do the math. If the market is there, he does.
I am doing the math. Yeah. It's like that is 625,000 rupees.
There
no, sorry, 625, 750, 875 a week.
Do you think we should close the podcast and become bail puris? Is that your message to us after 500?
That's 5 crores a year. Yeah, I think we should shut down.
5 crores a year?
And he's not in the tax net. No, that's if he works non-stop. Amit, he's a Gujarati and Amit. He's killing my friend from UP. He can't even sleep. He has to keep making bail. He can't go to 24 hours a day.
He can hire 4 guys.
Yeah, but then if 5
crores a year, I think he can hire more than 4 guys. No, but that's the thing.
He can hire 4 guys from here. We're ready.
500, what's the plate of bail? The plate of bail is 50 bucks,
40 bucks, 40. Not 30, 40.
40?
40 bucks in Malabar Hill, Cyrus.
Uh-huh. So how much is it where you live?
In Borivali, it's 15 bucks.
Oh, really? Oh, wow. Okay.
Wow. You mean I don't have to work again? I just moved to Borivali. With whatever I have, I can live. That's just fabulous. What a story. 40 bucks, Malabar Hill. And I've seen the growth from the 80s, late 80s, when I first bought bail puri in my school days. $2. Huh. Right? You remember 2 bucks?
I remember 2 rupees.
2 rupees. And all the way up down to 40.
Okay.
Yeah. Huge climb.
I remember 2 rupees. I seem to remember 5 rupees.
But
is
today,
being the longest
Ram Singh's son is in Cornell. You know what I mean? Look at the way he's...
Yeah.
Yeah, my son is in BIS. Same thing.
Look at our Muchad, no? He's
got branches everywhere. He's bigger than McDonald's.
There are four of them all in the same place, right?
Yeah. So all you need is a mustache and pan, and you're Muchad. No, that's your franchise.
It's literally the guy at the corner is one guy. The guy right next to
him is
one
other brothers.
Guy.
There's
four brothers.
But they all go. There's a split, right?
But it's amazing. All four of them are like kind of
the big families just can't get along in this country.
No, they can't.
Story of our lives. Let's get on with our show, young man.
Before we start, this is the 500th episode.
500th episode.
So we have something fun to do. We have a list of guests.
The only fun thing you could do on the 500th is shut it early. This is it. Good night.
So we have a list of guests.
Okay.
Who we would like to see, if you remember what the interview was like or what you liked.
That's
about
a terrible thing to ask. And if the guest ever hears that, they'll never come back again.
No, it's not a strict.
Okay,
test.
Listen. I've got dementia on my father's side of the family.
Okay.
I've got Alzheimer's for sure. Okay. And there's a lot of, like, today I forgot my protein. I make everything. You know, I'm very meticulous in the morning, and I separately 4 hours. I made all my stuff. I get my protein in one box and I lift it in the office. Yeah. So you know, this is Alzheimer's now striking, man. This Kajol, you're young. You have no idea what life is about. Ram Singh, on the other hand, $400,000 a week from bail.
Amit, would you like to ask us?
No, you go ahead, please.
Okay. Malaika Arora and Nikhil Chinappa were there on the 300th episode. You worked with them on your MTV days.
I can't remember the episode, but I know them very well.
I think the thing is, we want to ask him to remember stuff from, like,
from the episode.
Yeah. Just like say a few words about, like, how, if you remember what the interview. I doubt you remember what the interview was.
Malaika had a bodyguard.
Really?
That was my memory.
She roams around with a bodyguard?
At that point, she wouldn't tell me exactly why.
She didn't have him with her that day, but she has her with her normally.
He was there. He went down or something and stood. Because they realized there's nobody here that can affect her. We were all puny and weak. Yeah.
Okay.
And Nikhil was in a tight white t-shirt, I think.
Okay.
Because that really turns me on, Kajol.
Rajiv Masand was on an episode.
So Rajiv Masand, I love Rajiv Masand. Yeah. He presents his movies. It's always up and down like that. So we discussed maybe Salman, some of the big stars. I remember that because he's got some stories that I really love.
Yeah.
And Rajiv's the kind of guy you want on a flight or when you're killing time.
Yeah.
Rajiv has stories about Bollywood and about people, celebrities, famous people, not just Bollywood, all kinds of people.
Right.
And they're all great. He's like an encyclopedia.
Okay.
He can do a show where he just tells you stories, anecdotes.
Yeah.
And most people will like it. And he's quite, you know, dramatic and funny in his own way. I enjoy Rajiv Masand. I have a vague memory of that episode.
Okay.
Yeah. And he talks as fast as I do. So, you know, in 40 minutes, we packed away
got
like
a lot of
a million chapters.
Ishan Khattar. Actor Ishan Khattar.
Yeah, because he was being really nice to old men. He said all kinds of nice things.
So basically, Antariksh, you just decided to pick the most famous people from the list, right?
Yeah. The people I knew. And the people
you know. But that's from your bloody episode, man. It's not mine anymore. So this is not so challenging because these are people I know.
Okay. Yeah.
So I'll always have some memory. I think.
Clinton Serejo, the musician Clinton Serejo.
Well, I remember him, but I can't remember what he talked about in detail.
Yeah, I don't.
But I remember him.
Okay.
500 episodes. This is going to be the worst episode of all.
Yeah, I think
our standards are low. You know, I mean, it's not like, you know, really high.
I was in two episodes back when I was there.
Yeah.
Yeah. The Twitter feedback was like, "This is the worst episode ever."
No, it wasn't. It wasn't the episode that you were on. It was another episode.
You weren't there. And Akash Mehta was there.
Okay.
And it went off into undies and, you know, the stuff Akash likes to talk about.
Yes, of course.
Yeah, so we got slammed on that.
So now we'll blame it on Akash.
Yes.
But we have a couple of episodes which went even beyond that frontier.
We
lowered the bar even further.
Subterraneously
speaking, you know, it went underground through earth and beyond.
Okay.
There have been episodes which have not been appreciated.
Yeah.
There have been guests which have not been appreciated.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yes.
Have I been appreciated?
You have been appreciated. You are always fun to have on.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yes. People love you. In fact, I think I'm out. Okay, so Clinton, I have a vague memory. Then
Rapper Divine.
Yes, he became a big name.
Yeah,
he was a big belly boy and everything. When he came on, he was big.
He was big, but I don't know anybody except Vic Richards.
I know.
I think that helps also sometimes. Then when I went back, I went down. He and I exited at the same time, and some four kids crossed the road to meet him and all that. Four young, you know, yuppie type kids from one of these fancy Bandra car colleges, and they came rushing to meet him and take selfies and all that. In fact, one of them gave me the camera so I could shoot them. So, outstanding memory. Even told me, "Uncle, Uncle, tum piche jao, aapka haath hai frame mein." Divine.
Yeah.
Saurabh Pant, comedian Saurabh Pant.
I don't remember what we talked about, but again, I remember him.
This is, I remember him coming for... He came to publicize his book, no? He was doing a book at that time.
Yeah, maybe.
There was some fantasy book or something that he had written.
Yeah.
I think he had come for a book.
He's a fairly sexual man. I felt a little touching and all happened throughout the show, yeah.
Ah.
Yeah. But again, this is not that difficult because I have... You can remember the face and the name and all that. I think the challenging ones are there'll be people who are less high profile.
Right.
And there's so many. And some of them are really interesting.
Some really interesting people. All right, let me throw
I met a gentleman at the airport who said I was on your podcast.
Okay.
Yeah. I want to say who it is now. I remember who it is because then he introduced himself again. But I was blank. It was not fun. It's like, you know that one person in every class nobody remembers?
Right.
Yeah.
That's a terrible thing, no?
Yeah.
Because you don't mean to be. This is no malice. This is not a malice thing. And that's why it hurts even more.
Yeah. What do you do when
because sometimes you ignore.
In?
No, but sometimes you ignore people. You don't like them so much growing up. So like you pretend to be haughty and all that. Yeah. Zubin, yeah, whatever. But this is that one person we all have in our school or college or colony or something where you grew up and you just can't place the guy. Yeah. So that's just not. It's just so mean. Actually,
no, it's not. It's not. It's not intending to not remember.
It's not intending. You're praying to God. Ki mere ko dena kuch. Oh. I can't understand. But he's there somewhere.
So, I have a horrible memory for names. And when I'm hosting a comedy event, and I ask people, you know, what's your name and all. There was one guy who was the sixth person I asked, and he's like, I'll tell you my name after you tell me the names of everybody you've already asked.
Wow.
I couldn't remember a thing.
Today he's the highest paid comedian in India. Yes. Wow.
Honestly, that's kind of messed up, right? Why would he do that?
He was messing with me.
Yeah. See, I'm
messing with you. Yeah.
Wait, but it's also that I forget a person's name the moment I ask him.
But you're supposed to.
You don't understand. This weapon only works with people like me. I'll tell you why. It's a win-win situation when you're on stage and you use the audience. Because if I say something funny to the audience, they love it with the person. If the person does repartee to me, they love it that, you know, he's
somebody's
attacking
taking
me.
You on.
Because I'm a cocky guy.
Yeah.
So you should leave this only for the cocky guys. Because either way, we win. It doesn't matter, you know. It's like, he's so funny. I got it back. Either way, we win. So for me,
that's true, actually.
It's the safest thing. But for you, you're like a nice person. So you have to be very careful. Because either he'll look like a prick or you look like someone who's a little like not you know, I paid good money for this show.
I always take the hit and say, I don't remember. But I try to remember.
I'll give you tell you what to do. Take Ram Singh's number. Get him to come and do a spot where he makes bhelpuri. And he shows you how fast he can make it and how quickly he can deliver it. He's just fantastic. Yeah. These guys are geniuses and the Padma Shri is going to all the wrong people. Mm. I feel today I am going to write a list of people who should get our prizes. Dronacharya downwards. Every award is going to the wrong hands. Let's get back to the 500. That's a coaching award.
That's a
award.
Sports award, right?
Yeah, coaching award. Yeah,
okay,
yeah, yeah,
all right,
yeah.
Okay.
It's a big one for me. Big one for me.
Yeah. Who won it last year?
I have no idea. I'm bad with names. Just don't. Me and Kajal don't get names. We can't be telephone operators. The boss is who called? Singh? Sharma? Sebastian? Subramanian? Something? Sir.
Then we've had a number of producers on the show as well. If you could say a word about the producers, that would be nice. Like Naveen has been on.
Oh, Naveen just called me. The comedy festival got cancelled.
Yeah, I did.
Because of coronavirus.
Circuit, yeah.
He's looking for a job now.
Oh, wow.
But he doesn't even walk dogs, so I don't know how I can help. What can I do? What can I give someone? What? I mean, I'm an open-hearted guy, but what can I employ you to do? You tell me. Drop my kids? Have you met my kids? No. Dogs are a better option. But Naveen's not confident. I don't know. He's saying it's a gay thing. I'm saying, what's gay? Dogs are all bisexual.
Yeah.
And some dogs are dogs. You know? I've seen a dog who just jumps on like a tree trunk or, you know, a fake leg, you know, a pole. I mean, talk about sexual fantasies. I mean, really. God, what kind of porn do dogs read? Where were we?
Yeah. Then May was a producer as well.
May. Oh, let's finish with Naveen.
Naveen.
So we interviewed Naveen?
No, I think we did.
We did one episode with Abbas. Very sad we didn't do it before because he had his own unique voice. Oh. But working with him for such a long time, I was sort of, you know, I was used to all the Naveenisms.
Yeah. Right, right.
Yeah.
Right.
But he was a fun guy.
Yeah.
I have nice memories of his hair.
Who was your first producer? Your first producer was... Chavi. Chavi wasn't really.
There was no interaction really.
Yeah,
enough
because she was here for a very short time. I seem to remember either Vagish or Mali produced you for first initially.
Right.
No? Okay.
You're right.
Okay.
When in doubt, just ask my assistant, who is very good with names.
I only know Abbas, yeah.
I seem to remember Bageshwar Mali. So when we were working on a famous car,
me,
right?
I remember.
So, again, May never really produced you per se, right? I mean, like, because...
No, she didn't produce at all, actually.
Yeah.
I think only you were sort of the producer.
Yeah, so I was doing that, and then we got these two kids on board at that time, right? Bagesh and Mali. And I think one of them was working with you before.
Was it May? Male or female?
So Bagesh would be male and okay. Mali would be female.
Right, right. Oh. Okay. I remember them as if it was yesterday.
So you remember Bagesh. Bagesh has the leper poop story.
Yeah, correct. Right. I remember the story now. I'm just struggling with the name.
Yeah, I can't remember who, but I think maybe both of them were doing it because we got both of them on board. We only
there may be more.
Shows.
It's been 5 years. 5 years is a long time.
Yeah, so there haven't been that many people here, right? So yeah. It was initially me mostly. Then after that, Vagish and Mali. Then after that, Naveen. After Naveen, Abbas. After Abbas, Antariksh. We've been actually fairly kind of...
Stay for some time because man can't remember names. Yours is bad enough. Antariksh and Silverie. You know, no what happened to Bob? It's a nice name like Bob. Don't we call Bob anymore? I mean, it's Bob.
You know, in Devil Wears Prada,
Meryl
Streep.
Movie.
Yeah, Meryl Streep just keeps on calling all her assistants Emily.
Yeah.
Yeah, because she can't remember.
I think that's the way to do it. I like numbers as well. 1, 2, 3. That's great. I don't know why people can't do numbers. I don't feel bad about numbers. Footballers have numbers. Cricketers have numbers. What's the big deal? Number 10, number 15, numbers.
So Antariksh is 5.
Sure, you want to be 5?
I'm 5. Like chronologically, I'm 5.
Take 6. Yeah. It rhymes with pricks. All right, that's the level of the show that we put up for 5 years.
Yes. Yeah.
Kajol, she's been a guest as well, by the way.
She's probably one of the most frequent guests, right?
I mean, no, that's different. She's been a guest.
We've had most frequent guests.
Is she?
I would think so.
Yeah, because of Cock and Bull, the same roster of 8, 10 people.
Exactly. Yeah, she's been
female guest for sure. I can't think of a second female guest.
Because I do. Let's not.
She's the only female who enters.
Let's not dig into that too deeply.
She's that token female in the serial.
I see Cyrus is giving his Women's Day message late.
because women's message to me is every day.
But no, I think Kajol probably between you and Akash and Kunal. You got to be the three most frequent, like...
Not Kunal that much, actually. Kunal not that much. Kajol, Akash. There have been others who've come and gone. They have a little time. You
like
know,
Shriram's been on a couple of times. Yeah. Shreyas has been on a couple of times.
I think Puneet Pandya has come on.
Puneet and Pandya has been on a couple of times. But I think Kajol and Akash for sure. Like, by far the most.
Yeah.
Kajol, you get the prize.
I get the prize.
You're the Ram Singh of our show. You're the guy who can spin off 5 crores in Bhelpuri and not pay tax. And vote for any political party you want and they can't catch you because you don't exist. You're a ghost. That's Bhelpuri true. Ghost.
I'm very glad, Cyrus.
Yeah. Okay, I think that's it.
Yeah,
I think
so. Enough reminiscing.
Yep.
Okay, let's get to the topics.
Yeah, oh, there's topics as well.
Yeah.
I thought you were going to segue to these shows you mentioned.
Which one?
Naveen Narona cuts to... Naveen, tell me more about your life. So it's not going to be like that?
No, man.
You flattered to deceive.
We don't have that kind of production.
And nobody wants to work.
Time.
Okay.
Yeah, right. that's too much work.
We nearly reached the break time. Let's go.
Okay. First story is cricket related.
Okay.
Harbhajan Singh's bat got stolen on an Indigo flight from Bombay to Coimbatore.
Kunal Kamra was blamed.
But yeah, he was on a flight and he had given his bag.
Yeah, so you know what the story is. You can't carry a bat with you.
Right.
This is like a weapon.
Right.
So they have to put it either in the thing or if you're a famous celebrity, sometimes the pilot will, in his discretion, keep it and give it to you, like how they keep the coats and all that.
Right. Yeah.
But they hand it to you, or they take it off as you enter and they hand it to you as you exit.
Right.
Because in case Harbhajan loses his temper, must hit Shrisant with the bat.
It's going to be a problem, yes.
Yeah, exactly. But so now you're a celebrity, so I understand because it's a keepsake for them. You know, he's a famous cricketer and so you want to keep the bat. And so I can understand that. But sometimes when things are stolen and which have no value, like really, do you want to steal a cricket bat? Like, what are you going to do with it? You're an executive in a bank or something and you come back with somebody's cricket bat.
It'll be worth a lot
bat.
Of money.
No, but send
but
it,
if
send
it's
it
Harbhajan's bat, yes, but not, I'm saying generally.
No, I mean, sure they took it because it's Harbhajan's bat.
But even with Harbhajan's bat, how much money can it
what if Harbhajan stole his own bat? It's all about insurance fraud.
I'm telling you. But also, like, a bat is very important for a cricketer because all the strokes and all this, right? They've been practicing with that bat for a while.
It's Harbhajan. He's a bowler.
He's a bowler, really.
No,
he's made a few runs in cricket as well.
I don't understand.
No,
why.
His point is that it's a very personal thing, which is correct.
Sure.
Even for bowlers, if you have a bat, it's a personal thing.
But don't they have to change their bat every 6 months, a year, every year?
Not anymore. Yeah. These bats are damn good. They last much longer.
How long?
And there's luck, there's superstition attached to it and stuff.
Yeah.
Really? I haven't changed my wife. How many years is that? Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Same question of strokes and stuff.
Comparison.
Yeah. Good. Nobody stole her. Kept her outside the aircraft. <three times. laughs> Came back. Hostess. Is she gone? No, sir. Still here. Not only that. Once I left her there, and there were three of them when I came back. It's amazing.
I was hosting an event last night.
Really?
It was Women's Day.
Wow.
And this woman asked me. She's like, "You want to take my husband? Just take him, no. Take him, no." And I was like, man, this is not that sort of an event.
Well, husband must have been quite gay, no? Must have been like, it's a very good
smiling.
Idea.
He was smiling. He was smiling. Yeah. I could see the happiness.
It's his wife's suggestion. You can't blame him. Me, Lord, I'm innocent. I didn't even have this idea in my head. Never looked at another woman till she suggested. Yeah. All right. I think we're going into the break now.
Sure.
Because this is the longest episode ever, and I just want to stop at the right time. Do you want too much of a thing can kill it.
Yes.
So be very careful. Okay. Yeah. That's why I hate that song, Please Don't Go. Everybody, download Please Don't Go. It's the same line 427 times.
There's another
don't
line.
Go. Please don't go. Please don't go.
There's
don't
one
go.
More line in that, please in that song, isn't there?
Please don't go. Don't go. I'm telling the viewer.
Oh.
Or listener. Please don't go. We'll be back in a few seconds.
Hi, my name is Anupam Gupta. I'm B50 on Twitter. I am the host of Paisa Paisa, the show that talks money. On my show, I speak to experts from every field of money and finance, from stock markets, equities, debt funds, credit cards, life insurance, every possible area of money and finance that you can think of. We even did an episode on cryptocurrency. I've got fantastic guests from mutual funds to personal finance experts everywhere, robo-advisory, startups, just name it, we've got it. At Paisa Paisa, we help you make smart decisions about money. You work hard for money, now make your money work hard for you. New episodes out every Monday, and you can listen to my show on the IVM Podcast app or any other podcasting app that you have.
All right, we're back after a special break here. Yep. Episode 500, second half. Huge moment for all of us. All so proud. Waving my bat to the audience. Harbhajan's bat, which I found on the plane, Indigo plane. What was he doing on Indigo? He's a rich man. Oh, there's no choice now.
Yeah.
Some sectors, you just have to take what you get because we're running out of airlines. Okay. Close this one down, close that one down. No planes here. Yeah. Engines are wrong. This is what you got. Yeah. All right, while our research analyst from RAW is going through Please Don't Go lyrics, I think it's time for us through Silverie to address the nation.
There are actually a lot of lyrics. It's a full-on song.
So, Amit, you get to sing it to celebrate the 500th episode at the end of the episode. But for now, what do we have?
Okay, next story is, this is quite funny. US porn sites seeing growing interest in users searching for coronavirus related content. So people are searching for
sexual content.
Yeah, like quarantine sexual content, quarantine sex or something like that. And
they
about
want to see people than, in like funky
with the virus having sex and dying.
Like wearing masks
basically
and so,
wearing the hazmat suits.
Yeah. Can you have sex with hazmat suits?
Well, you have to hazmat suits
saying?
Open in strategic places, but I would have to
the sex
some.
The problem is getting a partner, not the suit. Haven't you understood Indian men?
Listen,
we don't have a problem with the damn clothes.
If you're in quarantine with someone, then at some point it's like being on a desert island with a guy, right?
Yeah, but there are some people you just can't have sex with.
I agree.
I've been told this many times. Sweetly, she says, I agree. Too late to take that back. It's done now. You insulted the gentleman here forever.
I have not insulted you.
But I wonder how far that goes, you know, when you're on a deserted island. I mean, just think about it. If two people, just the kind of person you're repulsed by, come on, it must be. You think? It's like food. You're repulsed by a lot of food, but if there's nothing else available, when do you break?
So
I don't like poha at all. Uh-huh. So when do I break? Supposing 3 days I don't get any food and that's all I have.
Right.
So when do I. Well, what's your breaking point? That's
I think
the right
3 weeks. 3 weeks in
for
a desert
island. 3 weeks for sex.
Yeah, 3 weeks in a desert island.
God, Julie's easy. Easy, Silverie. Easy boy. Calm down. Don't shave your beard in a hurry. Stay where you are. Get us some custom made suits, some masks. Let's put this all to test and get some poha in case I change my mind.
So he goes on to say, a search for the term coronavirus on Pornhub yielded at least 112 videos featuring sexually explicit content where hazmat suits and face masks were involved. A performer creator duo for the platform basically said that they have been making these videos specifically for people in Wuhan, in Hubei, in China, where a lot of the coronavirus cases have been originated.
To cheer them up?
Basically, I
or
guess.
Or something
that's
to do. There are two options here. Cheer them up or something to do.
But I'm sure if it hits India and we have hazmat suits, there'll be a lot of TikTok videos with
about
people.
Hazmat suits?
Style.
I'm sure there already are.
TikTok
are.
Videos are normally 15 seconds.
So 1 minute, 1 minute.
1 minute. This is typical Indian male's performance time.
Okay, this one is interesting. It goes on to say, it's a direct quote from the performer duo. They say, "We are all searching for things that make us come alive. COVID-19 is something that brings fear and mystery to pretty much everyone in the world right now. You need to be able to feel something, and what better way to make you feel something than the global crisis we are all in right now?
So Delhi
I'm obviously not the right market because I just can't find the connection. I'm trying so hard.
It's basically so porn's always had this habit, right, of like basically surfing the current,
the populist.
Yeah. What's going on right now? Whether it's like doing movie parodies.
Hence Batman, the classic, Batman legend.
Correct. Yeah. Okay. Sure.
Not that I've watched either.
Wasn't that Howard Stern's thing? No, that was Fartman.
No. Batman is, I mean, cinematic glory. Not something I want to discuss because I've never seen it.
Of course not.
It's not allowed by the Indian government.
Yeah, you don't watch any of that stuff.
Yeah, I mean, you shouldn't even watch Batman. I mean, that guy is all wrong. You know, he's a crazy, weird fellow who talks in hushed tones like that, even when he's talking to friends far away. That's about, I'm Batman, I will kill you. But, you know, you're talking to someone who's 150 meters away, can't you shout once? Batman never shouts. He never goes, it's me, Batman! He never says that. He's like, it's me, Batman. What the hell?
Interesting. No
wonder.
All of the
Robert left,
like all of them. I mean,
all
like,
of them.
All the actors.
They've always played. Well, Adam West and all is different, but
not Adam West, but like
since the 90s, Michael Keaton onwards.
Did Clooney spoke like that?
Yeah, all of them. Every one of them has this gravel tone and this talking soft, and you know, it's like
No, but when he gets angry, he does like I'm Batman.
Yeah, but it's still that grain.
It's still that.
This is
that
release.
Correct. It's always that.
It's a double grainy.
I think that's part of it.
Yeah.
Interesting. Val Kilmer also.
Now you're really pushing it, man. I can't remember.
I can't remember every Batman
actor.
No, so I can remember all of them, right?
Confess. Like I only watch Batman, and I've seen everything. And there's no gravel tone there, and a lot of repeat words like yes, 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 that kind of thing. Sort of script you want to write as a writer, you know, I'll get up in the morning, I'll write Batman part 2. Yes, 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 yes. Wait, okay, yes, yes. Sorry, next question.
Okay,
a movie's called Batman. It's all yeses. I'm sorry, never mind.
It's a very permissive society, Amit. You've lived in India too long.
Okay. Right.
In India, sex is not always about yes and no. I understand what you're saying.
Right.
Yeah.
Excuse me.
Oh my God.
Coronavirus.
Yes.
Okay.
You're laughing it off, but I think you should wear a mask.
Yeah, I think you should wear a mask.
We all should, man.
Yes. No, I'm not coughing.
What? You will be now.
By the way, the mask is worn so others don't get it. You understand that?
Yeah.
You already got it.
Yeah.
So we're wearing the mask so that you can't give it to in case you have it.
People don't realize that.
No, they think they're saving themselves.
They think they're saving themselves.
Because there's no Indian in the world who would do it otherwise. You know?
Yeah, exactly.
Wear the mask, you'll feel better, auntie. It's not you, it's for us. It says Batman in his tiny voice. Maybe Batman talks like that because the pants are tight. Just if you hold yourself in the nether region, your voice changes. It really happens.
It goes higher, though, not lower.
Or softer.
I think he wears a jumpsuit, no? Like, it's a onesie.
What movies are you watching? You're watching some Prison Break movie and I don't know, you confuse the actors, maybe Val Kilmer or, you know, Michael Keaton, one of these guys is in it. I don't, what's going on? Or are you watching The Eternal Travels of Batman?
Okay, next story. It says, innocent cyclist became a burglary suspect when cops used his Google location data, to find out that he was riding past the house during the break-in hours, about thrice. Basically what happens was this guy passed the house
recce's,
thrice.
Yeah.
On the day of the burglary.
Yeah.
And cops,
he did three recce's, and so they picked up the...
But it wasn't him, it was an innocent person.
Well, he did three recce's in the same spot, so it's an honest mistake by the cops. What the hell was he doing?
So I think
he was in rounds.
The question is...
like, are the police able to get your location data to that extent?
Well, they can. So the question is, should they be able to?
Should they be able to?
Data's right. Yeah. He just didn't have an intent to rob anyone.
He didn't, yeah. He was just a random person.
I think the point of the story is that basically does geofencing as a law enforcement tool make sense?
Right.
Should we use geofencing?
I think we should.
I think you should use it, but obviously innocent until proven guilty. That's just... You have to verify.
Exactly, it's a tool.
Yeah.
It's like a surveillance.
Like Batman has a tool.
Yes. I generally find all cyclists and marathoners quite suspicious. I mean,
he
gets off at 5 a.m. in the morning and runs around the place.
And shaves.
I know, exactly.
If Baba Ramdev doesn't shave, he's a 5 a.m. specialist. I mean, give him credit. What the hell's going on? Yeah. And what I hate is the arrogance of these people.
Yeah, man,
because
they're the healthiest people on earth.
No, forget, you're talking about I'm talking about the way they dominate physically. They just take over the stretch because it's a city, right?
Yeah.
So now this is our time and you cars should figure it out. What am I doing at 5 a.m.? Driving back from a stand-up show. Sold out. Yeah. Sorry, Silverie, we've got this whole thing going on the side.
That's all good.
Yeah, no, but I think that's the question. The interesting thing about this is just that, right? I mean, like that if you... should you be able to identify people based on their location without any kind of this? I think you should. I don't see any difference between this and a video camera.
Exactly.
Also, once again, CCTV. So he took three rounds. This suspicious behavior. I'm saying you can look at it.
Yeah.
You didn't put him in jail for that. You just check. Yeah. Because it is fishy. Why are you doing the same area thing at the same time as a break?
They have the same routes.
Yeah, so that makes sense to look at it.
Yeah.
Then you find out that, you know, he's a building fetish guy who gets off on buildings. He feels sexual, you know, love for the building.
You have weird trivia, Cyrus.
No, just relatives. My relatives are buildings. One of my aunties is B. As in, you know, she's not even Tower A. I'm sorry. If I have 500 of this, are you serious? I can see people in Batman suits choking each other. Kill! I'll kill you. You kill me. What happened to Robin?
What happened to Robin? He's around. Boy Wonder. He had new show on Netflix, no?
Really?
Titans.
Titans.
So he's come out of the closet or not?
So it's actually like hyper violent show, man. It's kind of crazy the way they do blood spray and stuff like that.
Wow.
It's a hyper
violent Robin the sociopath. So in green tights.
The idea is that it's like basically a bunch of these secondary heroes get together and fight crime.
They fight crime or they become negative characters?
No, they are, I think, they're mostly positive, but they're like not
negative-ish.
Yeah, they're not nice positive. They're not like, they're DC anyway a little dark, but this is darker than dark. Yeah.
Also, in the comics, there have been four different versions of Robin, or five different versions of Robin.
One guy is Ruben. No, that's my cousin from UP. That's a different story. There's no Batman there.
Okay. But there have only been two. There's been Dick Ward and there's been
Dick Grayson.
Dick Grayson and Burt Ward.
No, Dick Grayson is the name of the character. Jason Todd was the second Robin. Okay. Then Tim Drake was the third Robin.
Okay.
And the current Robin in the comics right now is Damian Wayne, who is Bruce Wayne's biological son.
Oh, wow. Okay.
Also 10 years old. Yay.
And what about Gotham?
Crime. Huh?
Who's Robin in Gotham as it progresses?
No. So
Gotham in the TV show Gotham?
Yeah,
no,
it goes on to Batman.
No, Titans, the one Amit was just talking about. In that, it's Dick Grayson.
Is it Titans?
Goes on to become Nightwing.
Isn't it Titans? You don't pronounce it Titans?
No.
I like Titans.
I think nobody is.
I'm sure you do.
She says with an inscrutable smile. And the infant from this 500th episode and stupid sexual double innuendo crap humor. Fair enough. Sir.
Okay. Moving on to the next story. This one says, boyfriend reaches into pocket to pay for the bill. Accidentally shoots girlfriend instead with stolen gun.
Wow.
Yeah.
Accidentally? Or was this too much? Why didn't you have the pizza?
And that's how they caught him. So he basically stole a gun from somewhere. And he was hiding the gun in his pocket. He was sitting at a restaurant with his girlfriend. Reaches in to pay for the bill and shoots his girlfriend by accident.
One of those feather touch buttons, obviously. Otherwise, it'll make no sense.
Well, yeah, it was uncocked or something.
Yeah, what's his name? Because I think I've dated him.
Oh, what?
I always date men who order fish and pomfret and all. And at the end of the meal, they're like, where's the closest ATM?
Actually.
That's
so classy.
It's not classy.
Really?
Wait, what?
But who's supposed to pay? I mean, now what happened to the egalitarian, sexist, non-thing? I heard all this about you should not offer to pay. Why should you offer to pay?
The thing is,
you're old-fashioned. You want the man to pay.
No, I want it to be Dutch.
He pays in marriage.
Listen, Cyrus. Even when things are going well in the month, I don't go for like the pomfret, which you've got to ask.
Well,
them.
In the month, as in physiologically speaking?
Financially speaking.
Oh, okay. No, let's be clear. See, the issue here is who's paying for the meal.
Yes, we don't know
then
that.
Then we'll come to the ATM thing is rubbish and bad.
You don't
behavior.
Meet someone for a date and like, that's not the first thing.
Look. This is not, the first date I'm talking about. Conventionally speaking, in convention, and taking convention as the point, what do? You ask the girl, the guy asks you out. He asks you out, right? First time.
Yeah.
So, is it supposed that he has to pay? Having
no,
asked
of course
you
not.
It's,
of course not.
It's a split bill most often.
Is it?
Yeah.
When I was growing up, we had to pay.
When I was growing up, 20 years ago, I used to pay. Now I don't know.
But I didn't pay and there was no ATM is different.
Yeah.
Well, I had a different technique. I was like, I just have to pee. And then I never come back. But, longest pee ever.
Back then it was guys paid. Over now it's very much.
But she has to answer this question. So tell me honestly. Do you like it when the guy pays for you?
No, I don't.
Or you want him to not pay for you?
I want it to be Dutch.
Yeah.
But I don't want this whole where is the nearest ATM conversation to be had.
No, that's ridiculous. That's so unclassy. It's very sad.
It is.
Who
very
did that?
Sad.
It spoils the name for all of us.
So could
have just run away. Had a heart attack. You know,
I mean,
shot himself.
Why are they even talking about an ATM?
Said he's gay. There's so many options to get away from paying.
At the restaurant, right?
Well,
Yeah.
It happens. I'm not saying every guy does it, but
no,
yeah,
but
it
it's just a weird thing to do. I mean, like, you don't have cash. I just use a card at the restaurant.
I mean, we all used to have budgets, all right? So if the budget went over, this kind of thing would have to happen because you didn't expect you had $500, the bill came to $601.
Right.
Then he's in trouble. He has to figure out some drama here, otherwise he's in big trouble. He's can't ask her to pay.
Well, no, but I mean, like, you still see ATM cards today are debit cards. You can use them in any restaurant.
But maybe they were
so he is either saying, hey, I got a dine and dash, or
I normally date writers, content specialists, comedians,
superheroes.
Not superheroes. I don't think these people know their finances very well.
this guy was doing a piece of comedy then?
No, he wasn't.
So my ATM dash routine, see if it works. Kajol, check it out. I'm going to end my show with this flourish. Okay, audience, we'll have two more jokes, but I can't afford them, so I'm just going to the ATM.
Maybe he just wanted to buy a cigarette. Maybe he wasn't asking them for the restaurant.
He left her with the bill.
Oh, he left you with
the bill. No, he didn't leave me, but then...
He came back.
No, the thing is, when you say...
He didn't come back, so he left you with the bill. It can't be both.
No, it's like this. Where's the nearest ATM? I'm like, I don't know. He's like, is it close by? I'm like, why don't I just pay for this and we can figure it out later?
And did he pay you back?
I don't remember. It's not one guy I'm talking about, Cyrus.
What?
Yeah, well, guys do that.
Is it the same restaurant?
No, seriously, you're dealing with the wrong guys.
Yeah. I don't date anymore.
Just go on Tinder and meet some old man.
Employed people on Tinder, Cyrus?
No, there are. I have friends on Tinder, so I know. There are very successful, financially successful people are there on Tinder. They don't want to give you profiles which are true. And they are much better with networking with people from a strange district. like a South Bombay guy will be happier in Thane. Or Delhi, or, you know, Portugal or something.
Because his wife will find out otherwise.
No, there's much more confidence in the creating the avatar and all that goes with that, etc. Obviously, there's other implications. Fair enough. But I'm saying he'll treat you better. He's at his best. While this comedian you're dating over, what do you say, event guy or whatever.
Content writers and graphic designers.
They seem to all be either struggling financially, misers, bit of both, or, you know, I mean, it's scary that the same woman should get the same treatment all the time. And that's what Amit Doshi wants to investigate.
That I like.
So you just like cheapos.
I like cheapos.
She likes cheapos. Speaking of cheapos, what's in it for me in the show?
What's the next topic?
Silverie is looking upset.
I didn't understand what that meant.
Everything I said made sense. We'd have a sponsor by now.
Cyrus's cheapo reference was to himself and his legendary cheapness. We had a rant in the beginning, remember, about the phone?
Correct.
I don't see myself as cheap, but I really don't have a money. I don't like spending money. I've just never liked that.
Also, cheap.
Maybe, but cheap is more about how much you want to spend. Like, when a beggar comes to me and asks for money, I've always said, like, I'll give you a biscuit. And they've actually called me names. I'm like, what the hell? Beggars can't be choosers. You shouldn't be giving me that. But they give me lectures all the time. Yeah. Because I always keep biscuits for dogs in the car. So, this may sound wrong to some people, but biscuit is, when you're hungry, you know, whoever you are, dog, gorilla, whatever, biscuit's a biscuit.
Right. Yeah.
But they want a special, like a full, you know, 500 rupee note, special color. That's too much, man.
Yeah.
Unless they can perform. And by that, I don't mean anything dirty.
Okay.
Yeah, because, what do you mean?
Like, sing a song. You know, be like think I'm in a reality show. And
They need to be like the...
Gareeb, abhi kuch gao. You know, because I'm a sensitive guy. The poor person will go, sapna mera phoota gaya. Nahi chalega. I don't like your personality that much. But you could hold a note, so one biscuit. or shake hands, fetch, whatever, you know, whatever comes to my mind. Yeah, well, back to you, sir.
Okay. This one is... Sharks love jazz music but don't get classical music, scientists have revealed. So you can, like, apparently...
As against plants who love classical music.
Really?
That's true. They get better and all that. You know, it's like...
They grow better.
They bloom.
Children also, right? I mean, like, apparently if you play...
Not Osama.
But if you play classical music to kids before they're born, like, you know, prenatal stages, those kids have better mental development in the long run.
Well, for my kids, I use my organ a lot. And so they have that.
All right.
So I think they use it with cows.
We're just going to let that sit. We're not going to go anywhere with that.
ATM cheap comedian is okay. But my one double... come on, you judgy people.
I'd
rather chat with my bigger friends.
I think they use that with cow as livestock. to make them basically the meat taste better.
No, in India, cows have to listen to religious music.
Okay. Yes. Not in India. I'm talking about like in foreign production.
I read the article. Okay. They just use jazz music to call the sharks to eat meat.
Basically. But they respond only to a particular kind of jazz and not to classical.
No, no, they came for both. Like they wanted the meat.
The vegetarian sharks prefer the classical music. The non-vegetarian sharks prefer the jazz.
So I didn't read the article because you had like something which you sent in the email. Yeah. Which seemed to make you more happy than the article. Then I thought that was what the story was about.
He finally has a conversation he can have at Tarapurwala Aquarium. Hey guys, did you know
Tarapurwala has no sharks? Huh? It's got pomfret. It's got shrimp.
Parsi Jibkana is nearby. So they ate the shark.
The menu.
Pomfret and prawns.
Are they're empty tanks? Yeah, it's really.
You all are joking about this, but my good friend Kunal Vijayakar did a play called I'm Not Bajirao with Sudhir Joshi, the legend of Marathi theatre, and Baman Irani, who became a legend in time. And they went to Singapore, and Singapore, as you know, is that famous
the ocean world. I've been there.
So these guys, first time in Singapore and all that, you know, just dazzling for those who don't know, dazzling colors and animals. I mean, just hit your senses when you're like animals or not, just the colors.
Underground aquarium is the most beautiful thing I've ever
underground,
seen.
Underground, and you go through the whole thing, just hitting you, color. And Sudhir Joshi's wife, God bless her, tells Kunal in Marathi, looking into the thing, and they're all looking, and Kunal says, wow, look at the colors. And Baman says, look at those colors, are electric. And this woman looks at them and says, how delicious. And everybody stops for about 3 seconds. You get what you get.
It's a true story.
Sorry, you're not happy, Silverie.
No, it's all
we three of us laugh at everything and you don't. It's so sad. Are you oppressed?
No, I'm not. I'm just looking up the rest of the story.
What story?
The sharks.
Oh, okay.
So basically, I never read the story because he put a comment at the end saying, read the comment.
There's only one way to find out. We need to just find out by actually going into the deep and with
trying
two
it out.
Sets of music and see which arm of yours is still there. Shit, like Mozart, huh? You bastard! I'll never ride my bike again because of you.
There was an interesting comment which I found was really funny. Was basically the article says sharks love jazz music but don't get classical. Scientists reveal, and someone had written, "Yep, sharks are assholes because they don't like classical." This stuff I thought it was funny.
He's going to be one of those comics who has to apologize for him. It's fun.
Okay. Last story is Bolivian woman inserts cocaine-filled condoms in private parts to smuggle drugs worth ₹1.55 crores.
But that's not the first time.
That's not the first time.
It's very common.
The mule thing.
But I haven't heard this happen in India so much.
Yeah.
No, but now India is becoming a big play for a lot of people.
But cocaine is generally. So I mean, like,
are you mad, Amit?
What?
The whole Delhi-Bombay circuit is huge.
Of course, it's huge. I'm not saying it's not huge.
I've seen you with some white powder.
No, you've not.
After Shah.
No, you've not.
Okay.
Yeah, but I just think, which condom brand would you trust that much to put cocaine into? Like, what would not leave? Because I would love to know.
I want to know if you're as cheap as me, would you use the used condom just to save money? So, I mean, because it's worked once. Why spend more? It's lying around here.
So I've read a book which talks about like cocaine smuggling and stuff like that. And so apparently, you're supposed to use generic brand latex, non-lubricated condoms for smuggling drugs in.
But do people trust condoms that much? Because
1.2 billion say no. And speaking for China, who's not seeing the best of times.
Also, it said it has to be inserted in a semi-liquid kind of form.
Are you going to now actually demonstrate?
No.
Because there's only one lady here and I will not be the guinea pig. Alright, I think it's time for the AMA.
I think we should let this
500
go.
Should have just been a break for the listener and me. Let's just go to 501. We can do that. You know, numbers are always at the lucky number, unlucky number. Buildings don't keep 13 for whatever reason. I hate that.
That
12,
true.
Next floor 14. It just irritates me. I feel like constructing it myself.
Yeah, I agree with you. I think that's dumb, right? Because
dumb.
13 is 13, right?
Yeah.
At the end of it.
Yeah.
Whether you call it 13 or 14,
absolutely.
It's still 13.
Yeah. So now 14 is actually 13. So who are you kidding?
Yeah.
Idiot. Just count. Sorry.
Agreed.
AMAs? Shall we go? Boom. Press the button. AMAs.
Hey everybody, welcome to another awesome, amazing week on the IVM Podcast Network. If you aren't following us on social media, please do. We're IVM Podcast on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram. We'd like to thank our sponsors this week, HDFC Life and Paytm Money. Sponsors make this stuff possible. If you work for a brand which you think would benefit from sponsoring show on IVM, please do reach out to us. We appreciate that. We have three new shows releasing this week. Uncle Please Sit, it's a podcast where Tushar and Joel speak about and strip away the misinformation of fact-free opinions that we often encounter in public. Stay tuned for the first episode releasing this Monday, the 9th of March. We're starting a new podcast called Smile India, hosted by Shifa Maitra. This podcast is both in English and Hindi, and it tells us about the uplifting and positive news from around the country. Episodes drop every Monday and Thursday, starting 9th of March. And Absolutely Right is a graphology podcast. That's right, graphology. Host Aditi Surana deploys her superpower of handwriting analysis and unravels some traits and characteristics of guests, including me and a whole bunch of people from IBM who you're familiar with. Stay tuned for the first episode releasing this Wednesday on 11th of March. On Advertising is Dead, Varun is joined by Tarika Soni, the head of monetization at Snapchat. They talk about content in the world of social media. And people, Edges and Sledges celebrated its 100th episode last week. Go back and listen to that if you haven't yet. This week, they talk about the Women's T20 World Cup India versus Australia final. And on Begin the Journey this week, Ashish shares a short story on dreams and joining the dots in our life. On Simplified, Tony Naran and Shrikant discuss the world's happiness index. On Paperback, Rachita and Satyajit are joined by the host of Litnama, Lakshmi Krishnan. They talk about women's role in writing and fiction written by women. On The Habit Coach, we have a Women's Day special where Ashton talks about periods, PMS, PCOD, and other taboo subjects which shouldn't be taboo at all. On Geek Fruit, Dinkar and Jishnu switch things up and talk about some pop culture other than movies that they've been following, from YouTube channels to reality TV shows. On Mr. and Mrs. Binge Watch, Janice Aniruddh discuss season 2 of Narcos Mexico. On The Empowering series, Zarina is joined by actor Jim Sarb. They talk about the art of storytelling and his unconventional characters. On Postcards from Nowhere, Utsav shares some fascinating stories of Bengali food. And with that, let's get you on with your show.
Follow me at Instagram and Twitter on Bored Brocha. I'm so bored, I need your help. I need your love. I need your touch. Okay, just follow me.
Back to the AMAs.
Yeah.
Vivek Priyadarshi asks, "Hey Cyrus, reporters from Indian news channels shove their mics into the mouths of all kinds of people to gain TRPs and state that it is their duty to do so, as the nation wants to know. Why aren't they interviewing patients who have tested positive for COVID-19? Cheers, Vivek."
Where do you want them to put the mic, though? They put a mask on. So I'm not trying to get sound from this guy. They're like, "Ma'am, would you mind bending over because I can't get sound?"
He seems to have a thing for mics. Yeah. That seems to be the point.
I don't understand the question.
I'm not worried about Silvery. I feel he's a psychotic man. I'm slowly finding out.
This was something else he found funny. Yeah.
No, this was a question he's asking. Why aren't we hearing as many?
It's a fair question.
But how can you interview people who already has coronavirus because you don't want to contract the virus?
You can. I mean, as a journalist, these are interesting points. Right. If you can talk to a victim and tell us what he did or didn't.
People want to talk to victims. People are talking to victims.
But our famous celebrity anchors don't want to step out of the studio.
But our famous celebrity anchors never step out of the studio.
Yeah, true.
So I mean, like, you know,
is that junior reporter who has to go through the whole virus thing and hopefully not contract?
I'm sure that our senior celebrity anchors would be happy to do a remote with anybody who has the virus, right?
Yeah. So happily give the virus
if it increases
the TRP.
I don't understand the question over here, other than the cheap joke at the Nation Wants to Know expense.
Yeah.
Which is fine. I mean, like, I'm happy to make jokes at Nation Wants to Know expense all the time. But
exactly.
I mean, I don't get the point of the question.
Let Silvery make his point.
No, I saw this video over the weekend, kind of related to coronavirus thing. So this person, I think it was Iran or somewhere, because this guy is standing outside the hospital speaking in a supposed Arabic language. And he comes out of the hospital, sees that reporters are standing outside just to interview the person coming out. They ask him, "Hey, are you fine? Have you been cured? Can you leave the hospital?" And he's like, "Yeah, I'm cool. They said they got me in yesterday to test me for the COVID-19, but I'm fine now." And just then, doctors come running out. Like, "Oh my God, how do you come outside?" And they pull him back inside into the hospital.
That's a nice story.
And the article said, "A man lies about not having coronavirus, gets caught live on TV."
Jeez.
It's hilarious.
I would do that. I hate hospitals. If I'm feeling good enough, there's no reason to stay there.
To stay there?
Yeah. And why care about humanity? Honestly, what have they done for me? I mean, there's a guy who took her to dinner and then ran off to find an ATM because he exists. I mean, come on. People are scum. Yeah.
No kidding.
Okay, going on to the next question.
Yes, please.
Jitendra Mule asks, "Hi Cyrus, Hello. I've been consistently listening to the podcast and the new episodes."
They say it like it's a crime, you know. Like, I don't know how to respond to that. I'm so sorry.
Okay.
No, we thank them. Thank you. Keep listening. Listen to more. Tell more people about the show.
There's also a surprise implied in the question. Like, can you believe it? I'm one of those few guys who's heard this. I mean, that's mean, I get all the negative tone here. You know, I never get a positive tone.
Really?
I feel terrible.
I think that's the way you take it.
I feel sad.
Yeah.
No, but I think that's how you're looking at it, right? Yeah. Read the line again.
"Hi, Cyrus. I've been consistently listening to the podcast and the new episodes are very good. That's what he says.
And the new episode. See, again.
Okay, so now
only the last three.
Yeah, so
500.
Now it feels a little back.
There you go.
Although missing Abbas's voice. He goes on to say,
we can play Abbas's voice at any point. Abbas going, next question.
Wow, that's a great impression of Abbas's voice.
Especially when we're all hyper like this. Everybody's screaming and shouting, fine, Donald Trump is a truth. Donald Trump. Can we move on? And all of us look at each other like, dad's in the room and we're all, drinking alcohol.
He's got the most calming voice ever.
Yeah, very calming, I think women will like him until they see him.
I find Abbas very attractive.
Well, is he the guy who couldn't go to the ATM?
No.
All the time Abbas gets up. Abbas is the guy who will eat both your dinners. That's what I thought. But not only will I pay for it, I'll eat it. I think that's enough for you. Watch your figure, lady. And now watch mine. Glub, 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 glub.
Okay. Jitendra goes on to ask, I don't get it when people put their glasses or goggles on their head.
Oh, that's me.
And I've seen in most of the pics and videos of yours that you do the following.
Yeah, so mine is I lose.
What does it signify?
Okay, I have a problem. I never carried a pen, pencil or school bag, college thing. I hated all those things because I lose things. That's the main reason. So whatever I have, I tried. That's why I lost my protein bottle today. I'm so upset because I know if I have things in my hand, I don't take them with me. So I keep this on my head so I don't lose it. And there's no other reason. And it's the only thing I don't lose are my glasses. If I take them off, I lose them. Left my kids once like that.
I buy that, right? I mean, like,
it's all practical. It's there's nothing else to it.
Yeah, no, it makes sense to me.
Yeah, because I know I lose it. If I carry a bag, I leave the file behind, I leave the books behind, I leave the pen behind. I left my dad behind once at a party. You don't know what you do.
So we've literally tried this out, right? So the pens that I use are different than the pens that we get for everybody else in the office. They're the same, but they buy them separately.
It's a cost thing.
No, it's just me. Just because I want to figure out what the hell am I doing with these damn pens, right? Yeah. I mean, like every month, 15 pens, gone.
Don't talk to me about pens. In college, we just carry these pens. You never took the pen back.
Yeah.
So what's the point? I said, everybody gets, it's like an NGO for pens, the college.
It is.
Everybody brings pens, they lose the pens. All the stationery just lay around. Nobody took stationery back.
I lose 15 pens a month. And they're not expensive pens, right? It's like 15, 20 rupee pens. But I mean, like 15 pens a month.
And you're always thinking, what have I brought? What have I brought?
Where have I gone?
Who finds these pens? Like,
that's what I'm losing. Where do they go?
People like me find it because I don't have pens. So I'm happy to, Akash, is that, okay. And I just quietly take it. Just like that.
Yeah. What do you think, though, is a better place to put your goggles? Above the heads or on the collar?
No,
under your neck?
Head.
Head?
Collar and all that. I get like, scratches and touches me and all. I'm a ticklish guy.
I think it depends on what you're wearing, right? If you're wearing a t-shirt without a collar,
it
then
touches
you,
the leg of the glasses, always touch you when you're driving or walking and all that.
Why don't you get one of those bands which you can hang around your neck?
That's too much work. Remember, now what you're saying is every day, one more second of my life, find the band, put it on my head. No,
if
no.
If you were wearing a shirt with a pocket, wouldn't you rather put it in the pocket, though?
No, because it gets lost. It falls out of the pocket.
In the pocket?
Yeah. I've tried that. It doesn't work. I've been putting on the Belka thing loop. It falls off. Okay. And I've broken it while sitting.
Belka loop can break, right? But in the pocket, just straight in the pocket?
No. This is fine. I don't even remember it being there. Plus, these are my mother's glasses. And she checks and tells me, have you brought my glasses back? Because I've broken all my own glasses. So I just use everybody's second hand. Mohit Mahali, my producer, gave me a pair of glasses. Another boy in promos gave me a pair of glasses. All gone. Kunal bought me pairs of glasses from Dubai. My wife gave me on our anniversary a very expensive pair, which I can't pronounce with a French name. And I lost it in Dubai itself. In the sand dunes. And only later I realized that when you're going on those rides, you shouldn't have sunglasses on.
Yeah.
It's really not a smart thing to do. But by the time I lost the glasses, and I came home and she said, where's the glasses? And I was like, it's there somewhere. I lied for 6 months that I had them. I was so scared. I wouldn't mind telling I lost it, but I couldn't tell I lost it in the sand dunes because it sounds like you're a moron. You go up and down in those cars like that. Nobody will wear bloody sunglasses. And not keep them on their head there too. Yeah. It just went off. Boom. Somewhere in the desert are my sunglasses. If you see them, please return them. Yeah.
Okay, let's move on, guys.
Last one. I've got to move on, literally.
Okay. Yeah. This is sent in by Ishan Pai. He says, hi, Cyrus. It's Ishan here from Andheri. I wanted to ask you, have you seen Guilty on Netflix starring Kiara Advani? Did you like performance of Kunal Vizhaikar?
I don't watch stuff in Indian languages. I have a mental block for... It's a five-year period. I'll start doing that in 2021.
Kunal's in this Guilty thing.
He's in Guilty, and apparently the role has been changed a little bit from the way he was told and then what they've edited.
Okay.
So he may have been playing a male principal, and by the end he's playing a female footballer. So I can't wait to see it. But the funny thing is, I'm the only one who doesn't know who Kiara Advani is. Everybody I ask, so do you know? She, apparently she's a really big star.
She's and, become this new one,
but
right?
No relation to LK.
Yeah, that's true.
So you know she's a very big actress.
Yeah, she's the South Indian who became.
And her mother was a teacher in JB Pettit.
Oh, really?
So I was being informed. Yeah, full South Bombay girl.
Your kid goes, right? No, she used to go.
I don't know. I don't know more than this, but I've been getting information.
Okay. All right.
And Kunal is one of those guys who I think he feels very impressed with famous people.
Okay.
He's always been like that. So he was like, Kiara Advani, she's really, I'm. And then I found out he's not really opposite her. There's no romantic scenes. He's playing some fat old principal in Delhi College who's twice seen outside the window or something. You know, I don't know. But I can't, I won't be able to watch this. I'm guilty as charged. Okay. I won't be able to watch it. Have you seen it?
No, I've not seen it.
Yeah. Have you seen it, Amit?
No. Yeah. I spent the weekend watching Bosch.
But I've seen Bosch. There are only 5 seasons.
Yeah, so I watched the 4th season.
I thought Bosch is basically, for me, Javed Akhtar doing Boss. Bosch.
It's a great book series. You should read the book series. Michael Connelly.
How can I read the book after watching the thing?
Because
it'll be so slow.
No, it's so different. Each season of the show incorporates multiple books. Books cross over multiple seasons. It's there are 22 books.
Is season 6 Big Bosch?
Okay,
stop it. Don't answer.
Yes.
Can we do one last?
Very fast. I'm answering it before the question. Yes.
Hi, Cyrus, Amit, Silverie, and guest. My name is Amaya. Congrats on completing 500 episodes.
Yeah,
naturally, after completing landmark like this, people would usually ask you what your favorite episodes and interviews were. But after listening to recent Cyrus Says features, I was wondering if you ever interviewed any guest in the last 500 episodes that made you feel, why the fuck am I interviewing this person?
One out of two.
And you need not reveal the name of the person.
There are 250 names. It's going to be me years. Just go. Just take a pick. Yeah. But I think 500 episodes, you cannot have 500 great guests.
No, you can.
Or more than that, 500 great experiences. Let's not blame personalities. Yeah. Because it's a chemistry, you know, when you're doing a show, I guess. Mm-hmm. So, you know, things happen or don't happen. But I don't think we've been too bad. I would say maybe less than 5% would have been
I would not
even good.
Go that. I wouldn't even go that far, right? Yeah. I think that I can count like maybe 3 or 4 times when I'm like, that's not really working, right?
I mean, I would still say that any episode that you watch, you will still end up laughing a lot, regardless of who the guest is, because of
I don't know about that, but I'm saying that, you know, I've tried to make the guests feel comfortable.
Right. Yeah.
Sometimes they don't understand what we're saying, and it may be things like that.
Right.
Or, you know, Kajol will come and make some sexist comment against men, and that's caused a lot of trouble.
I'm sorry, Cyrus. I just
wanted to
respond to your sexist comment.
Stop the fire. Okay. I'm not a sexist. I'm a eunuch. I've been a eunuch for many years. You know, I told you I got 3 powerful females in my life, 4 if I count my dog, so that's, you know, there's no question of me being anything but a feminist. You don't have to be a feminist out of choice. Sometimes you're just a feminist because there's no other way. Please understand.
It.
Yeah. God. I mean, are you a feminist, Silverie?
I mean, sure.
You're the voice of reason.
We should all be. We should all be feminists.
You have to become Abbas now. Your tone has been lower. Abbas is the Indian Batman. Okay. He's like that. Yeah. Let's catch the criminals. Our tribute to all the producers. Anyway, thank you for listening to our 500th episode, and hopefully we'll keep going.
Yes, we will.
All we need is your money and your love, but more your money.
Send us some money.
Yes. And your love.
Money's more.
And tight pants. Okay, catch us on any of the podcasting apps, please. We beg you, we need you. Send us your questions on Twitter on Cyrus Says In, or you can email us, even if you're not female, on whatcyrussays@gmail.com.
Hi guys, this is Ayushi.
And I am Ritasha.
And welcome to Agla Station Adulthood.
It's a fun podcast we've got going on, and we'd love for you to tune in and enjoy with us.
Join us as we stop at various stations and discuss different topics that seem to be bothering us, and hopefully
dating,
you as
relationships,
well.
Relationships, beauty, just being an adult, lots of different things.
We don't have a great grip on it, but we've done okay so far.
Catch Agla Station Adulthood every Thursday on the IBM app, the IBM website, or wherever else you get your podcasts.
माणसांना गोल गप्प्यासारखी असतात. हाय हॅलो करताना वेगळी आणि बोलताना वेगळी आणि गप्पा मारताना वेगळी. मित्र झाली की वेगळी आणि शत्रू म्हणून वेगळी. थोडक्यात दिसणारी वेगळी आणि असणारी वेगळी. कधी आंबट, कधी गोड, कधी तिखट, तर कधी चमचमीत आणि कधी कधी हॉट अँड स्पायसी सुद्धा. आणि म्हणूनच गप्पा, सॉरी गोल गप्पा विथ तृप्ती खामकर फक्त तुमच्यासाठी दर बुधवारी IVM पॉडकास्टच्या ऍपवर, वेबसाईटवर किंवा युट्यूब चॅनलवर सुद्धा ऐकू शकता. तुम्ही आमचा पॉडकास्ट वेगवेगळ्या पॉडकास्ट प्लॅटफॉर्म वरती ऐकू शकता. फक्त सर्च करा गोल गप्पा विथ तृप्ती खामकर आणि आमचा पॉडकास्ट ऐकत राहा.